Welcome back, Chuck Chews. For lunch today, we're going to do Marie Callender's meatloaf and gravy. That looks absolutely nothing like what came out of this package. This is disgusting looking. Doesn't smell horrible, but it doesn't smell good either. The corn's all dried up and shriveled. This meatloaf looks like, I don't know what that looks like, but it doesn't. I've never had this meal, or at least I don't recall ever having this meal. So I'm putting this down as this is my first time having it. We'll start off with the pull tab thing on here on the end. Didn't work worth a hoot. Meatloaf in a home-style gravy with creamy mashed potatoes and corn. Ah, my. Well, I just heard water run in the house, and there's nothing on. You know, I read the stats and everything on the back, which I don't know if anybody really cares about, but I also never give the actual size of these meals. Like this one's a 12.4 ounce size meal. And the one thing that just keeps distracting me on this thing is there's a line that goes up. You can actually feel it on the box. It goes up, around, all the way down the back and around. At first I thought it was when they were cutting the big boxes open at the store and nicked it, but it's a perfectly straight little crease. One of those things that just catches your attention and you just can't let go of it. All right. Mashed potatoes with real butter. Golden sweet corn made from scratch gravy. Yeah, it's made from scratch by these big, you know, 6,000 gallon vat with these big gigantic paddles, and these guys open up bags of stuff and pour into it. If that's what they call made from scratch, then yeah, I guess that's made from scratch. Classic meatloaf. I've had some classic meatloafs. That thing looks pitiful. It's not appetizing looking at all. I'm sorry. I know I'm hounding on that, but I should make one of my meatloafs and put a video out about it, and you would see what a real meatloaf looks like. Mine looks good, and it tastes good. All right, to make this thing, you take it out of the package, cut, film the vent, cook it on high for 4 minutes, stir the potatoes, and rotate the meatloaf. Now, it doesn't say when to rotate it. Are you rotating it this way? Or are you rotating it this way? Cook an additional 3 to 4 minutes. Check that the food is cooked thoroughly, handled with care, it's hot, let stand for 2 minutes. Okay, we've killed that much time. You can do this in a conventional oven, but do not do in a toaster oven. For 350 on a baking sheet. For 40 to 45 minutes. Cut, film, event. Nutritional facts. This is one meal. 370 calories. Total fats, 15 grams. Cholesterol, 55 grams. Sodium, 1260. Yikes. Total carbohydrates, 37 grams. Protein, 21. Ingredients are all on the end here. This is a Conagra Brands out of Chicago, Illinois. Do I have to keep saying Chicago, Illinois? Everybody should know where Chicago is at. Contains milk, wheat, and soy. I'm going to go out on a limb right now and say this is going to need pepper, especially the corn. Corn always does in any meal, no matter what it is. Whoa, a lot came out of there. Oh, man. Man, that whole bunch just dumped out of there. All right. Well, it can't make it taste any worse because I have a feeling this is going to be pretty bad. Because it just doesn't look appetizing at all. I'm sorry. It just doesn't look good at all. All right. Here we go. Oh, I should have got me a slice of bread. I can't say that it's bad tasting, but I can't say it has a taste at all. I mean, either my taste buds are shot, or it's just no taste at all. The mashed potatoes are just runny. I mean, they stick on your fork, but you can tell they're runny. That gravy, first of all, there's not enough of the gravy. Gravy and all that great either. Mashed potatoes. So far, this thing has not been anything great about it. Usually, the corn's the best part of some of these meals. But this corn, I mean, here's a piece that looks like it's been blasted into next week. Here, have a piece of corn, dog. Nope. Corn's not good either. Most of the corn is shriveled up, dry. Almost like it's been overcooked, but I cooked this at the minimum times it said to cook it at. So far, the only flavor I'm getting in my mouth is all the pepper I put on it by accident. No, this isn't good at all. I may have to do another lunch today. Yeah, this isn't good. Yeah, that's nasty tasting. If you've ever done the Marie Callender's meatloaf and gravy, let me know in the comments below if you like it or not. I'm not a fan of it. Of course, after you make your own and you perfect it over years, trying somebody else's meatloaf is usually no comparison, but if you've had this before, let me know in the comments below. Until the next video.